Alright guys, let's open another Perrin mod here. Thanks, of course, to Perrin for keeping the channel alive, basically, over some of the slower times. Without them, I'd hardly have anything to make videos about. Well, I guess that's not true, because I always come up with some idea. But, of course, very appreciated. So, today, we're gonna do the master cylinder brace. No nut certs this time, yay. So, and I got a brake reservoir cozy. I think I had one of these a while ago in some big package I got, but I don't really have it anymore, so nowadays, I would love to run this, and I will run this. It'll just soak up any of the spills and stuff like that. So somehow I'll stretch it around that when I'm done. I'll clean it first. It's kind of dark there, but actually, no, that's a good picture. It's kind of dark, but I'll clean it and stretch this around later. Now, the main piece. I don't see this talked about too often. Oh man, that's thick. Killer. All right. So what we have here is something that is going to rest on the tip of the brake booster to provide a lot more stability here when you're pushing it. I can even move this now by hand. Imagine that, whatever, 10,000 pounds of pressure on your pedal. And what this is it's going to give your brake a more solid feel, less flex. It may even help some of the guys with some of the clutch issues, which is caused by your whole pedal assembly flexing against where it is bolted to the firewall. And the fix through a TSB is to take it out and insert a special shim between those two items to stop the squeak. But this piece, just holding that brake reservoir a little more solid, may just stop a little bit of that flex. It's all related to the pedal system, you know? Just a thought. It may do something for that too. So let me see where we're gonna be at with this. All this is like three, I'll read the directions, but three bolts pretty much to the side of your shock mount. And then you just twist in a set nut and adjust it just how you like it. It's a pretty simple install. That's why I'm really stoked to go ahead with it. So let me get a rag. I don't want to keep putting this down on the dirty area. I'll be right back. Instruction is to remove your set screw and your nut. Now let me show you what we got with it. With one hand, of course. Don't want to drop these things. So then we got five pieces of hardware that came with it, aside from that. Looks like three similar size, and one, and the washer would go here. And I know what this is. This is three of these going into pre-existing holes, and I thought I saw a fourth hole, possibly in the back. I'm not sure if they're all needed. I thought I saw three holes mentioned. Oh, it is four holes. Right. Sweet. Oh, now I'm really getting it. I thought you'd have to do a nut and bolt for the fourth hole, but you don't. It's threaded. I got it exactly. This is a really nice product, nicely designed. I always say that, because it's true, man. I haven't even gone through this part yet and really show you. Let me get a nice good light on it. So it's super thick, super nice machined. And again, you have all the detail levels that you expect from Perrin. You got honed out holes there to sink all your bolts and make them nice and clean. Really nice thread pattern drilled into this. The Perrin logo, everybody knows so well. And even a jut on this bolt here to make it fit just that much better, just a little bit better. And they want to make sure that everything's solid. So just the machining that I come to expect here. Curved machining, I always love, it's beautiful, not just squares and easy stuff, but this is like really clean. Let me show you what that extra little hump is for that bolt we just looked at. It's your hump that my finger's on. The little zit coming out of that. So, I mean, we'll go into more detail as I do it, but you're basically going to use three of the existing holes you see there. And the hump one does not have threads. That is why your pairing piece has threads. You're going to go in this way with three, then come in from the outside for the last bolt, tighten them up, you're done. Then you're going to adjust your set screw. Real simple, real simple. Now this is primarily, well, it works on anything. I just want to mention the STI will have a fuel pressure regulator around that area that the WRX newer engine does not have. So you may have some more problems getting to that piece. It'll be a little harder if you have an STI, just for reference. But for the WRX, you don't got anything right in this area. It's real open, real easy to work with. Oh no, I have a personal issue. That is where, one of those bolts is where I keep my relay for my LED bar. So I have to remove it. I can always find somewhere else for that, but I have to get the mount installed correctly. So too bad, that was a perfect spot. I'll find another spot, see what I gotta do with those wires. All right, so I'm gonna unbolt it. I got a 10 millimeter way down deep under that relay I gotta remove. All right, so you can see that I unbolted my relay. Now I can get the three bolts in, wherever they go, and kind of see what's left. Yeah, I think it's the further one down, but I'm not positive. I can't tell by the length right now. So we'll see what fits later. I can just readjust the other one. So let me get these bolts in first. No washers came with these. That's all right. I'll go ahead and use these. Oh, duh. You're not going to be able to get washers because you have small little holes sunk for the Allen bolts. By the way, I didn't mention also it did come with two Allens. They are different sizes. Okay. So the big one's probably for your master adjustment, small ones for these. Okay, let me just get them hand started and I'll show you what's going on. Pull it out a little more just to get room, pulled out my relay to really get it out of the way. So all that I need to do there really is find a place to mount that afterwards with whatever. I still have a little play on this, or I can extend it if I need to, but I'm sure I can get it anywhere at all, really. Just barely fit it wherever I want. But I'm just pulling it out of the way so I have really good access to all the holes we need down there. It's pretty hard to get, I don't know how you're gonna get an Allen wrench in there. Let's see if I can, ooh, perfect. I can hold this just so I can at least show you, like, where's the screw hole? Maybe you can get it from underneath here. I can't quite see where the hole is. Is that it? If I can tighten it just with my, get it started with my fingers, because it's easy at first, just to get a few threads in so it stays. I think I got it. Yeah, I think it's probably low enough to get to reach it, access it under this, but I still think an Allen socket would probably be easier and a lot faster. Just want to make sure this is started so I don't end up dropping Allens. Okay, those two are in. Now I gotta do the bottom one. Which is even, actually it's the bottom one's easier because you got more room way down there. See if I can get it lined up somehow. There, I think I got it. Going in, that's my sticky hole because it freaking had sand and dirt in it because of the relay that was in there. All right, I won't show you just snugging up all these bolts. That'll take a while. Let me do that. Oh, let me show you the other one while I'm at it. Let's go around the side here. Where is it? Oh, you see it right there. Sweet. Okay. Maybe you can see it. You probably can't. It's just past that spring. But trust me, it's there. That's going to be hard to get to. Actually, the best way to get the screw in front of my finger, which is just probably out of your view, I'll show you it. Can you see it? Let me get a good grip. Yeah, it's the one we're looking at. Yeah, right in the middle. I'm pretty sure that's the shiny one. I can't tell on the tiny camera screen. So it's that one. The threads are waiting for you right there. So I'm going to do like an extension and an Allen socket. It'd be real hard to get your fingers in there. And I didn't actually open the instruction book yet. Maybe I should. You know, I've learned lessons before. Right side. Yeah, it just says install it through the hole there. It doesn't tell you any tricks. So I'm going to get a socket for this one. Of course, make sure that you just start all four before you snug anything up. Standard procedure for any job. So you can see I have a really long socket and I have it in there with the Allen, so I'm not going to let go. I got to start twisting, but that's how you can get to it a little easier. All right, just about there. I did get that one hand tightened. I got these two outer ones hand tightened. This inner one is a little bit trickier to get to. You can't really get a straight shot through there with a socket. I mean, yeah, I can just inch it through, but I think I might try my ball Allen wrench, which allows a little swivel, and that can probably allow me to get it. Yeah, the ball one is just gonna let me get to it, barely. But see, it's angled down, so you can't have a straight shot because the reservoir is in the way for that particular Allen. And of course, I didn't read the directions, fair disclosure. They may tell you a different way to do it or not, but they probably just want you to use an Allen wrench. I think I remember torque specs, so I'm gonna have to check that next. And then we'll do the final step, which is just the master bolt. Pretty awesome. You really get a feel that this is really sturdy stuff because it's held so tightly with four different bolt points, three in the center, three on the inside, one on the outside. It's just really well engineered. There, I think I got it. I think it's tightening up. I gotta look closer without being on camera. For fair disclosure, they do add a special note here that says, although they do include some Allen wrenches, an M5 hex socket with extension is a lot easier to tighten down those M6 bolts. So they even mention that. But yeah, you might need some screws, some proper tools to really do it quicker, or else you'll be sitting there with an Allen wrench for a short time. Upgrade, larger hole, 8mm in. Oh, there they are. The small bolts to 10 foot-pounds, the large single bolt to 20 foot-pounds. That's nice and simple. So close, you know, so far. 10 foot-pounds times 12, 120 inch-pounds. Ooh, that's too much. Nothing else matters. 115, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 120, that's 10 foot-pounds. This is gonna be my 6mm action right here. Let's see. I guess I could try to do one with you guys watching, but I probably just wanna do it alone and have my careful access. Oh, I don't remember if I mentioned at the start of the video. I think I lost my red jack. I did, well, I mentioned it maybe in a clip I didn't air. Fuck, that was sharp. What the fuck was that? Maybe it was a piece of tie wrap that's like razor. All right, let's see. Oh my God, this is gonna be really, are you kidding? How are you supposed to torque this thing? Okay, let's see what kind of extension I might need. It is really tight in there. I could get in there, but I won't be able to move much. Let's see. Okay, I need like a 2-inch extension to start with. Or I could remove this intercooler bracket right here, which is blocking the wrench. You know, it's so easy to remove the bracket. I think I'll do that. All right, this should work okay for that really hard one to get. Notice my intercooler bracket is gone from here. And that was blocking it right in the way of where you want your wrench to be. So I'm just trying to give it a little support behind it. It's getting tight. Oh, sweet. All right, that's the
That's the hard one. The other one should be easier. Yeah, this little ball thing sometimes gets sticky in there. Ah, come on. Oh, there it goes. It's that thing. But it saves a lot of lives, man, when you can angle your Allen a little bit, just like it did today. All right. This is probably too long for the other ones. Let me just see if I can get to them. Because it's kind of a nice setup. Yeah, too long for that one. I'll probably get the top one with it in there. And you got to hold like this AC line out of the way a little bit. Am I in there? Yeah. That's what she said. Okay, that's the two top ones. Now the bottom one, oh man, there's some definite lines right in the way of that. I mean, I don't need this long one anymore. It'll be a lot easier to set up a short one for this last one. For this last one, I'll just use a little two inch bobber. Get it in there, there it is. Now you do got lines here and there, you just gotta, see, it doesn't take much so you can get to them. Now they do recommend you check the torques on all these after a few days. So that's it. I don't need to do the rest. I already saw them torque. My OCD makes me go back again. All right, I won't get the last one. I know it clicked. All three of the insides are torqued. Now I'm gonna do 20 foot-pounds with their long extension on that bolt way under there. That's too hard to get light and film for. All right, so you barely have any torque wrench room here. You really gotta try and just get it click by click. I can't even get a click on it right now, but it is in there. Let me show you kind of what I got going on in there. So the key is just how you're gonna get the click. All right, I have one three inch wobbly at the socket side. So I go under that spring instead of over it. And that did it pretty easily. Okay, 20 foot pound. Now I'll get it out and I can show you what the tool I used if I can get it out. Dang. Whoa, there it is. Whoa, don't want to lose it. So that is the tool I used with a swivelly at the back only. Everything else is straight. Pretty long torque wrench. So make sure you come prepared with the right tools. All right, everything's torqued. Let's move on again to the fun stuff. All right, let's go ahead and hand start. You don't want to drop it. Hand start your big set screw. Of course, with the Allen side facing out, so you can adjust it. Then you're going to carefully thread your lock nut on there for later, once you get a nice angle of what you're looking at. Okay, it's not going to be that much lock nut. I got to get this thing so it hits the reservoir behind it. And then I'll read a little bit about how it did. There, it's tightening up. Let me make sure the lock nut's loose so it's not a lock nut issue. Let me hold this with one finger and film. Oh my god, okay. Right there. It might have been a lock nut issue. Get right there. There, I think it's just starting to snug up a little bit. So let me read it. Directions, I'll be right back. Alright, well I don't wanna overdo it. So it says tighten the set screw by hand until it stops, which is, if I really grab the Allen, which is hard, by hand, and then another half turn with the Allen, then lock it up. That's it, to set your preload. And, oh, you can see in there, see that? There it is. There's a little piece, so that's by hand, absolutely, as far as I go. I'm gonna follow directions for once in my life, and do what they say. And they said, well, I'll show you in a minute. Let me just get this half turn debobble done. Let's see. see. Is that a small Allen? Oh, it goes in there. It goes in there. Okay. It's just nice and it's precise. It's nice and tight. Let me see here. The best. I've got to get a good angle to make sure I can figure out a half turn. All right. So that's hand tight. I can end up over on this side. Let me make sure it's a half turn so I don't overdo it. Yep. Half a turn. Tadger preload. I don't know if I can even get it with this tiny. Yeah, this will work. Right. Ooh, it's getting real tight. Oh. Duh, that's my lock nut. So let me put it back right where it was. Lock nut fully out of the way because you don't want it obscuring your decision. Okay. There we go. Perfect. That's a half turn from that side to this side. Tighten it up, and that's the pretty much done there. Let me check a wrench size for you. It says 19, so the directions do tell you. I didn't need to figure it out. They told me. All right, 19. Beautiful. Right there. I'm gonna make sure. Yeah, the Allen isn't moving, so it's pretty good. It's a tiny, tiny hair. It's just about right. I got a little preload on that master cylinder now, as we talked about. A little more, but I always overdo it. That's perfect. Perfect. Okay. That is done. You got your preload. You got your brace holding that master cylinder front now. So when you push on the brake, and it normally can shift this all, a millimeter, a half a millimeter, whatever, now it's going to be more solid there. So the next thing, get inside the car, press on the brake rather hard, 3 to 4 times, recheck the hardware, and you're done. After 5 to 7 days of driving, just check them again to make sure. All right, guys, I did retorque it all. Everything was fine. I didn't need to, nothing was loose. So, am I gonna feel a difference in my braking? I highly doubt it. Is it great peace of mind and a nice piece regardless and just ensuring your brake solid? Of course it is. But am I gonna feel a difference next time I brake? Probably not. Most honest people would say that. But it's a very, very nice piece. Nice peace of mind for sure. And perfect fitment, absolutely. Right in the center of the brake master right there. Really nice design. And thanks again to Perrin. I'm gonna have to figure out what to do with this sloppy Joe right here. Do something with this bad boy, but it's worth it to get that brace in there. Results of the where I put the relay and stuff, in case anybody else has relays, just tied it to the back of those hoses there. The ground is still where it was before on one of those two bolts right there. And everything else, it almost looks factory because it's beside the fuse box and it's plenty tight. Ain't going nowhere. So that's the best I could do. I was trying to do a bolt thing and a bracket, and I said that's not even worth the time to worry about that. That's perfect. It's solid. Almost forgot one thing. Be right back. Clean all as much dirt as you can off it first. Can't see in the back, but I'll crush my finger and make sure. Okay, that's pretty freaking clean. Of course, that's because I clean this reservoir like every month. Ooh, there's some dirt underneath there too. Oh, that's mint right there. That's cherry. All right. Perfect. Where are you going? Where are you going? It's not recording. Don't worry about it.
You always say that.
Well, sometimes I tell the truth, don't I? Is this rusting?
I'm gonna go pick up.
All right. I'm just finishing up. All right. Oh, yeah. Time for the grand finale. Now, let's see here. Do I want it reading the front? It's too short to read anywhere. Huh? All right. Goddamn, she's going out to get the kids. I could put it on this side or the outside. Or even front, it'll stretch wherever. I don't want to break it either by stretching it too far. It's pretty tight at the back here. this dang thing is so, this one piece is really tight. I'm gonna do this carefully and be right back. Okay, so I would put the back on first. This is strong. I stretched it and it didn't rip. Okay. But I put the back on first because it's much harder to get to. I want it overlapping exactly even around the edges. Maybe even, yeah. Oh, yeah. Just hide that under the cap, you know? That's really nice. Actually, I like that a lot. I mean, how often do I need to get in there? Almost never. I'll just leave that. That's a sweet little brake cozy right there, ain't it? And it'll prevent, when you do have those tiny, tiny moisture and leaks, it'll soak it up, which is its purpose, and prevent it from getting everywhere else in your car. And this thing's gotta be cheap. I don't even know. It's probably $5. I don't know, maybe $10. Whatever it is. It's a nice little touch, especially on my Perrin modified car. Everything's done. I'm tired, but I'm glad, because I'd always rather have a mod than sit in my house and be bored. Quick updates on anything else. Let's see. I had to order another one of these. I can't live without this tire restorer, even though it's like $13. It's expensive, but I'm just about out of my other bottle. I had to buy that. The tip deal, I'm getting close to making my decision. I might post the one I probably will get on the Facebook. So I just have to do more measurements, because see, once I order it, I'm kind of screwed. I'd rather get it on Amazon so I can return it if it doesn't work, but you don't have too many choices on Amazon. So I'm looking at one that I'm gonna post a pic of on Facebook. I think it'll be just right. The biggest problem I've seen is they're all 9 and 10 inches, which could stick out like to here, maybe, and it could look a little funny, but I definitely can't get, you know, a 12 inch or longer. But only one or two come in 6 inch, and they're not that cool. Most of them are 7 and 8 inch, so it'll just be past the bumper a little bit. It might be perfect. I kind of wanted a rectangle tucked under this plane underneath here, but if it goes out a little bit, you know, I could deal with it if it's the perfect tip. Probably gonna get some chrome or polished action, and probably go with a black powder coat to test it. The tips are cheap, like $100 at most for a pair, most of them. Some of the real nice ones might be $150 for the pair. So I'm working on that too. I don't really need to show you the sound of the car, because it sounds pretty stock, which I love. Changing the mufflers from WRX to Forester made more of a difference in sound than changing the midpipe from WRX to STI. That was just more slight, and you could barely tell. Or it didn't change the tone much. Changing the mufflers, there must be a big difference in those mufflers, because all my growl and raspy idle at cold start is gone, which is what I wanted. And it still has a little tone, but it doesn't rip and cut into your ears quite as much, which is also what I wanted. So, you know, next drive video I make, we'll check it out and you'll see it, but it's pretty awesome. I love it. Just got to get those tips. I like the look right now, to be honest, just for being unusual, but I'm going to finish it up with some tips when I get a chance and get going on that. Thanks, Perrin.